Imagine this, a massive warship, armed to the teeth, patrolling the open ocean, thinking it's untouchable. Then, out of nowhere, a single bomb drops from the sky. Within seconds, the ship is gone, ripped apart, sinking beneath the waves before its crew can even react. This is Quicksink, a revolutionary weapon developed by the US Air Force that turns standard bombs into ship killers. It's fast, devastating, and nearly unstoppable. But here's where it gets even more interesting. In February 2025, Iran unveiled its first ever drone carrier, the Shahed Bagheri, a warship designed to challenge US naval dominance in the Arabian Gulf. But what if this bold move was actually a massive mistake? Iran believes this carrier will be a game changer. It carries helicopters, drones, and even small attack boats that could swarm enemy ships. But here's the problem. It's the perfect target for Quicksink. This video will break down exactly how Quicksink works, why it's so deadly, and why Iran's newest mega warship might not even last a day at sea. Because when Quicksink strikes, ships don't just take damage, they disappear. First, let's discuss the reality of sinking warships. Many people believe that if you hit a warship with a missile or a bomb, it will immediately go under. That's far from the truth. Modern warships are designed to withstand an incredible amount of punishment. During combat, even if they take direct hits, they often stay afloat for hours, or even days, before they sink. Take the 1980s naval battle between the US and Iran, for example. In a one-day battle, the US Navy bombarded multiple Iranian warships with missiles, bombs, and gunfire. Some ships took multiple direct hits, yet still refused to sink. They remained adrift, burning and crippled, but not fully destroyed. Why? Because warships have reinforced hulls that can absorb damage, multiple watertight compartments. So even if one section floods, the ship can stay afloat. Redundant systems, allowing crews to keep fighting even after serious hits. This is why sinking a warship fast is so difficult. It's not just about hitting the ship, it's about hitting it in the right place. And that's exactly what Quicksink is designed to do. This weapon doesn't just cause damage, it ensures the ship is gone in seconds. It doesn't rely on missiles, torpedoes, or heavy artillery. Instead, it turns an ordinary bomb into a ship-destroying monster. And that's bad news for Iran's new drone carrier. Because if a warship can't survive multiple missile strikes, how can it survive a weapon designed to sink it in one shot? So, what is Quicksink, and how does it work? At its core, Quicksink is just a regular bomb, but with a deadly twist. The US Air Force has modified the standard Mark 84 2,000-pound bomb, a weapon used for decades, and turned it into the ultimate ship killer. Let's discuss the evolution of Quicksink. Originally, the Mark 84 was just a dumb bomb. It lacked precision and was only effective when dropped in massive numbers. But over time, the US military upgraded it using JDAM kits, which gave it GPS guidance. JDA bombs turned regular bombs into smart bombs, capable of pinpointing a target with incredible accuracy. But there was still one major problem. JDAMs were great for hitting stationary targets, not moving ships. That's where Quicksink comes in. It solves this problem with a new technology called the WOSA Seeker, Weapon Open Systems Architecture. But how is Quicksink different? The WOSA Seeker is the key to Quicksink's deadly effectiveness. It allows the bomb to actively track and follow a moving ship, rather than just blindly falling to a preset location. Here's how it works. The bomb is dropped toward the ship's last known location. The WOSA Seeker activates and starts sending out radar pings, scanning for the moving ship. Once it locks onto the target, the bomb adjusts its course mid-air to ensure it hits the ship where it hurts the most, right below the waterline. This last part is critical. Most bombs or missiles just hit the upper decks, causing damage, but not sinking the ship. Quicksink goes for the weak spot, ensuring total destruction. This bomb will start a new era of naval warfare. With this technology, Quicksink turns a simple airdropped bomb into something that functions like a torpedo, but with the speed and precision of a missile. For a country like Iran, which relies on repurposed cargo ships as warships, this is an absolute nightmare. Their newest drone carrier, the Shahed Bagheri, is exactly the kind of target Quicksink was built to destroy. Now, how does Quicksink work? Now that we understand what Quicksink is, let's break down exactly how it works in combat. It all starts with the US Navy's P-8 Poseidon aircraft, an advanced surveillance plane designed to scan the ocean for enemy warships. Using a combination of radar, sonar, and electronic signals, it pinpoints the exact location of an enemy vessel, tracking its movement in real time. This critical data is then relayed to the US Air Force, allowing a fighter jet to move into position for the attack. Once the target is confirmed, an F-35 or F-15E Strike Eagle takes off, carrying a modified Mark 84 bomb. This isn't just any ordinary bomb, it's been upgraded with JDAM guidance and the WOSA Seeker, making it capable of tracking and destroying moving ships with deadly precision. The pilot flies at high altitude, staying safely out of reach of enemy anti-air defenses, before releasing the Quicksink bomb toward the ocean below. At first, the bomb behaves like any other guided munition, dropping through the sky at high speed. But as it approaches the last known location of the enemy vessel, the WOSA Seeker activates, sending out radar signals to detect the moving target. The moment it locks onto the ship, it adjusts its trajectory mid-air, steering itself to the weakest point of the vessel, just below the waterline. Upon impact, the explosion isn't just destructive, it's devastating. The detonation creates a massive underwater shockwave, violently forcing water into the hull and causing the entire ship to lift out of the water before crashing down again. This extreme stress snaps the ship's keel, the backbone of the vessel, clean in half, ensuring that it sinks within seconds. Unlike missiles or torpedoes, which often disable a ship without completely sinking it, Quicksink is designed to guarantee destruction. There's no chance for the crew to fight fires, patch holes, or keep the ship afloat. Once the bomb detonates, the warship is either breaking apart or vanishing beneath the waves. For nations like Iran, China, and Russia, this presents a serious challenge. Their naval strategies rely on warships remaining combat capable, even after sustaining damage. But against Quicksink, damage control won't matter because the ship won't be there to save. And for Iran's brand new drone carrier, the Shahed Bagheri, if Quicksink ever gets a shot at it, the fight will be over before it even begins. Let's take a look at the Iran's new drone carrier, the Shahed Bagheri. In February 2025, Iran introduced its first aircraft carrier, the Shahed Bagheri, calling it a game changer for naval warfare. But there's a big problem. This isn't really a warship. Instead of building a carrier from scratch, Iran took a cargo ship and turned it into a military vessel. That makes it very easy to destroy in battle. The ship started as a regular merchant container ship, designed to carry goods, not fight wars. Iran spent 2 years modifying it, making the deck wider so it could launch drones and helicopters. It also added some weapons and small attack boats that can be released from side doors. On paper, it sounds impressive. It can carry 60 drones, some helicopters, and small fast boats. But there's a huge difference between a real warship and a cargo ship with weapons. Unlike US aircraft carriers, which have thick armor, advanced radar, and strong defenses, the Shahed Bagheri has none of these things. It's built from thin commercial steel, making it very weak against bombs or missiles. If it gets hit, it won't take long to sink. Iran also claims that the Shahed Bagheri can stay at sea for a whole year without refueling. That is simply not true. Even US nuclear-powered carriers, which don't need fuel, still need supplies like food, weapons, and repairs every few months. The Shahed Bagheri runs on diesel, meaning it would have to stop for fuel every few weeks. There's also the issue of firepower. The ship doesn't carry fighter jets like US or Chinese carriers. Instead, it launches drones and helicopters. Some of these drones, like the Mohajer 6 and a Babel 3, are useful for spying and small attacks, but they can't take on real warships. The small attack boats Iran plans to use are fast, but wouldn't stand a chance against US Navy defenses. The biggest problem, though, is that this ship is an easy target. Because it was never built for combat, it can't survive an attack from modern weapons like Quicksink. A normal aircraft carrier can take damage and keep fighting, but the Shahed Bagheri would sink almost immediately if hit. If a Quicksink bomb were dropped on it, the explosion would rip through the ship's weak hull, breaking it in half and sending it to the bottom of the ocean in minutes. Iran may be proud of its first aircraft carrier, but in reality, It's one of the weakest warships in the region. Against the US Navy's Quicksink bombs, it wouldn't last 5 minutes. Here's why Quicksink changes naval warfare. For years, the best way to sink enemy warships was with torpedoes. The US Navy's Mark 48 heavyweight torpedo is one of the most powerful weapons in the world, capable of breaking a ship in half. But there's a problem. It costs $4.2 million per shot. That's an insanely high price for a single weapon. This is where Quicksink completely changes the game. Instead of relying on expensive torpedoes, the US can now sink ships using cheap airdropped bombs. A Quicksink bomb costs around $230,000, which is 18 times cheaper than a torpedo. That means the US could sink nearly 20 ships for the price of one torpedo. But cost isn't the only advantage. Range and speed matter too. Torpedoes can only be fired from submarines, which take time to position themselves for an attack. Submarines are also limited in number and can only carry a small supply of torpedoes. On the other hand, fighter jets and bombers can carry multiple Quicksink bombs and drop them from high altitude, staying far from danger. This means that the US could launch a massive attack with Quicksink bombs in minutes, while submarines would take hours or even days to set up a torpedo strike. For example, a US aircraft carrier carries over 50 fighter jets. If just half of those planes carried two Quicksink bombs each, they could wipe out an entire enemy fleet in a single airstrike. And that's just from one carrier. The US Air Force also has dozens of bombers and jets in the Middle East, ready to attack at any time. Iran's entire navy consists of only 39 surface warships. With Quicksink bombs, the US military could destroy Iran's entire navy multiple times over without even needing to use submarines or warships. This is what makes Quicksink so terrifying. It's not just about sinking one ship. It's about overwhelming the enemy with rapid, unstoppable attacks. For countries like Iran, China, and Russia, this is a nightmare scenario. Their warships are built to take hits and keep fighting. But against Quicksink, there is no second chance. If a warship gets targeted, it's not just damaged, it's gone. So is this the future of naval combat? The introduction of Quicksink marks a massive shift in modern naval warfare. Unlike traditional missiles or torpedoes, this weapon is cheap, effective, and can be deployed on a massive scale. With a single fighter jet or bomber, the US military can destroy enemy warships in seconds, from a safe distance, without risking submarines or surface ships. For Iran, this is a serious problem. Their new drone carrier, the Shahed Bagheri, is supposed to be a symbol of power, but in reality, it's one of the weakest warships in the region. It was built from a cargo ship, not designed for combat, and has no defense against weapons like Quicksink. If war ever broke out, it wouldn't last a day at sea. But Iran isn't the only country that should be worried. China and Russia also rely on large surface fleets to control key waterways. If Quicksink becomes widely used, entire fleets could be wiped out before they even get the chance to fight. The balance of power at sea is shifting fast, and countries that rely on traditional naval warfare might soon find themselves outmatched by a single bomb. The question now is, can anyone develop a defense against Quicksink? Right now, the answer is no. There is no known counter to this kind of attack. No warship can survive a direct Quicksink strike. So what does this mean for the future of war at sea? It means that the US military has just made naval combat faster, deadlier, and more one-sided than ever before. And for Iran's new drone carrier, if Quicksink is ever used, it won't stand a chance. What do you think? Will Iran encounter a powerful weapon like Quicksink, or is the future of naval warfare already decided? Don't forget to subscribe and let me know in the comments.